Every day, Westchester Medical Center Health Network is providing life-changing care. Our talented clinicians, bedside caregivers, and support staff touch the lives of hundreds of thousands of people across our 9-hospital, $2.6 billion healthcare network, which encompasses more than 6,200 square miles of the Hudson Valley. This past year, we had several breakthroughs across our network, and that momentum will carry us into 2024. For example, we are breaking the mold in how pediatric cardiac surgery is performed. Our approach is to correct congenital heart defects in infants through a small incision under the arm, rather than the more traditional approach of entering the chests of infant patients. This improves recovery time while reducing infections, pain, and lifelong scarring, and is strongly preferred by parents across our communities. In one of our more rural communities, we broke new ground, opening the new HealthAlliance Hospital in Kingston, New York. This hospital is equipped with technology and services that would rival any community hospital in the United States. In fact, we perform more than 900 cardiac procedures at this hospital in our first few months, saving lives by keeping the services close to home. And we initiated a new beginning, getting plans approved for our new critical care tower, which will be the Hudson Valley's hub of critical care medicine. This tower will bring together critical care and medical surgical specialties in one location, enabling Westchester Medical Center to convert to all private inpatient rooms across the rest of the campus. This 5-story, 128-bed tower will include all ICU-equipped patient rooms, a patient-centric design with leading-edge amenities to create a soothing, healing environment, and will house vital services for our patients and their families, including trauma, neurosciences, cardiology, and general surgery. Join me as we take a closer look at these and other breakthroughs as we continue to provide life-changing care across the Hudson Valley.
Caring for the critically injured and providing emergency general surgery continues to be part of the DNA of WMC Health. From our flagship hospital at Westchester Medical Center to all of our facilities, we have taken a network approach to these efforts by creating standards, protocols, and new programs in order to provide care not merely to a community, but to the entire Hudson Valley region. With the recent designation of Good Samaritan Hospital in Suffern and HealthAlliance Hospital in Kingston as trauma centers, we now have a truly unified WMC Health Trauma Consortium. Advances in technology have allowed for the evolution of surgical technique to minimally invasive procedures such as robotic surgery. Whereas robotic surgery has been well established in elective settings, we are proud to have developed over the past year the first bona fide program in robotic acute care surgery in the state of New York. We offer robotic surgery 24 hours a day, 7 days a week at multiple campuses for all of the most common general surgical emergencies. We have performed over 250 robotic emergency general surgical procedures since the inception of this program within the past year. And our experience with building this program has been selected for presentation at the annual Congress of the American College of Surgeons this year. Our goal is to extend this innovative program of robotic surgery to all of our facilities in an integrated fashion and to ensure that the communities of the Hudson Valley know that WMC Health continues to be the leader in providing outstanding care for both trauma and emergency surgery, regardless of when it is needed.
Surgical techniques for repair of congenital heart defects have evolved over the years with significant reduction in mortality and morbidity. The front approach or median sternotomy has been the gold standard approach for decades. On one side, it allows easy access to the heart, lungs, and great arteries, but on the other side, it has several drawbacks that include invasiveness, wound-related complications, slow return to full activity, and the visible scar that results in patients' and parents' dissatisfaction. The progress in minimally invasive approaches for infants and children with heart defects has been quite lagging in comparison to adults. At Westchester Medical Center and Maria Ferrari Children's Hospital, we have been providing an alternative approach for repair of a wide variety of congenital heart defects in infants and children. This approach is done through a small incision under the right arm and is known as right axillary thoracotomy. This is becoming our standard approach for a wide variety of heart defects, such as all types of atrial septal defects, anomalous pulmonary venous connections, and more. It has a cosmetic superiority in comparison to the front approach, associated with significantly less need for blood transfusion, significant shorter length of hospital stay, and much quicker return to unrestricted full activity, which all translate into better patient satisfaction and making this approach our new gold standard.
Seizures can be very scary for patients and their loved ones, and sometimes can be dangerous. In the past few years, Westchester Medical Center and Maria Freire Children's Hospital have made significant strides as the leading providers of epilepsy care in the Hudson Valley. Our epilepsy center holds the distinction as one of only two level 4 centers in the region, recognized by the National Association of Epilepsy Centers. More than 2,000 children had EEGs here last year. Central to our achievements is our multidisciplinary team of accomplished neurologists, neuropsychologists, neuroradiologists, and cerebrovascular neurosurgeons. This synergy ensures our patients receive innovative and leading-edge epilepsy care. At the forefront of innovation, Westchester Medical Center offers a range of tailored surgical interventions, from minimally invasive monitoring techniques, like stereotactic EEG, to cutting-edge treatments such as MRI-guided laser ablation and responsive neurostimulation. Our dedication transcends clinical expertise. We proudly pioneer epilepsy research. Notably, we were the first program in the country to enroll an adolescent in the groundbreaking RESPONSE clinical trial for responsive neurostimulation in pediatric epilepsy. Our amazing neurologists are actively engaged in multiple clinical trials and are exploring promising drug regimens for the future of epilepsy treatment. Witnessing our intervention's transformative power is truly inspiring. Getting to see children recover, their seizures abate, and quality of life restored is beyond measure. Our commitment endures as we push boundaries, nurture hope, and reshape possibilities. Westchester Medical Center remains resolute in fostering progress and making a difference in the lives of our patients.
Our cardiac center at Good Samaritan Hospital is renowned for its unified team of highly skilled surgeons, cardiologists, and electrophysiologists who perform coronary bypass surgery, surgical valve repair and replacement, cardiac catheterization, arrhythmia ablation, and coronary artery stenting. Over the last several years, we have started a highly successful TAVR, transcatheter aortic valve replacement program for patients with aortic stenosis, and a high volume WATCHMAN program for atrial fibrillation. Few community hospitals offer these procedures, and it's gratifying that we're able to help patients right here, close to where they live and work. It's truly a team effort with our nurses, PAs, perfusionists, scrub techs, and our anesthesiologists. The vast majority of all cardiac surgical procedures can be done right here at Good Samaritan Hospital. And through collaboration with our partners at Westchester Medical Center, we can offer the most advanced options quickly, seamlessly, and without delay for critically ill patients who need therapies such as artificial heart pumps and transplantation.
Glioblastoma is a malignant brain tumor that carries a uniformly fatal prognosis. Very little progress has been made in terms of treating this tumor over the last 20 years. At Westchester Medical Center, we are one of the few institutions nationally featuring a clinical trial designed for patients with newly diagnosed glioblastoma. This is the IMVAX Phase 2B clinical trial. This trial is very similar to the trends seen in treating other forms of cancers. It basically weaponizes the patient's own immune system to attack the glioblastoma. The way this trial works is that at surgery, when we remove the glioblastoma, some of the tumor is sent to IMVAX, where they incubate the tumor cells with a compound that causes the tumor cells to die. In the act of dying, these tumor cells release antigens that are specific proteins. It's a signature of that tumor. This solution is then put into small chambers that are sent back to us. 2 days after the surgery, we implant these chambers into the patient's abdominal muscles. While in the abdominal muscles, these chambers slowly leach out this solution containing the tumor antigens into the patient's lymphatic system. That allows the patient's immune system to identify the tumor antigens as foreign and then to attack the tumor in the brain itself. This is one way of bypassing the notoriously difficult obstacle known as the blood-brain barrier, which has kept many treatments away from targeting directly this type of tumor. At Westchester Medical Center, we've already enrolled 5 patients in this clinical trial, making us the lead enroller nationally, and we look forward to continuing to offer this treatment and trial to patients with this disease.